Thank you very much, Salim. The Honourable Minister, the Vice Chancellor, the Permanent Secretary is here, the Ambassador, delegates, all protocol observed. You're all welcome to the Pearl of Africa, if I may also say. And I have just a few minutes to share the outcome of the first ever national symposium that was held for CBA in Uganda. My name is Sophie Kutegeka. I work with the International Union for Conservation of Nature, IUCN, Uganda office. I'm glad to inform you that IUCN is one of the co-sponsors of this conference. I'm here to share the brief highlights that emerged from the symposium that we held, which we considered as a curtain raiser to this CBA11 conference. The symposium gave us an opportunity to learn about the different interventions being implemented by the various actors, and also it revealed that tremendous efforts are actually being undertaken by the various actors. But the main issue for us was, despite all this, why do we still have these challenges? I would like to inform you that the symposium was organized by the Ministry of Water and Environment in partnership with a number of actors. I want to recognize Mukri as one of the main organizers, Reproductive Health Uganda, IUCN, of course, Environmental Act, Care International, and Conservation Through Public Health, with many others. Because of time, I'll just go straight to the main recommendations we made from that conference. We hope that this can inform the discussions through this conference, and also we'll take forward these actions for implementation by the different actors. And we hope through the different discussions we shall have through this conference, these will be taken forward. Without a doubt, we know and we believe that successful and transformative adaptation, for that to happen, people must be put at the center of all climate action, while ensuring that their rights are fully recognized and respected. And that was the background of our discussion, and that's the reason why we're all here. We recommend, as a member of G77, that we call upon all partners to support the call for predictable, adequate, scalable, and transformative long-term financing for climate action. We know that LDC countries are really struggling with this, and we are recommending that the LDCs consider scaling up domestic budget as well for this kind of support to climate action. We recognize the need to manage population growth. So much discussion was held around that area, and also because we had Reproductive Health Uganda as one of the main organizers, one of our recommendations is that we need to manage population growth as opposed to controlling it. And there's a lot of confusion around that issue, and we are saying that people must be skilled and resourced adequately to get full benefits of quality population. We're saying that countries must prioritize the inclusion of private sector in their climate action agenda, but also, most importantly, beyond recognizing that, we recommend creating an enabling environment for the full participation of private sector for purposes of leveraging climate financing and technology transfer, which is very important. The issue of food security and sovereignty, we recommend climate smart agriculture being prioritized and adopted into farming systems, but most importantly, to have a common definition or framework for climate smart agriculture across the board. We are also recommending interventions at a catchment level. One of the reservations is, and one of the realization is that most of the interventions that are being undertaken are site-specific, they are being done in silos, and they are scattered all over. That answers one of the questions, why, despite all the interventions that are being undertaken, we're still having these challenges. So we are recommending catchment level engagement of these interventions. We're also recommending documentation and for all the countries to really have key messages, common messages. For Uganda, what is our common message on climate, on community-based adaptation? We recommend that that is adopted by the different countries. Also, for purposes of being able to demonstrate the proven interventions that strengthen local natural resource management, because different countries have tested those that really work for them. We recognize the high dependence on natural resources, and we are recommending that CBA interventions need to prioritize the sustainable use of biodiversity, ecosystem goods and services, and we are glad that the theme for this conference is actually in line with this. And as a country, we call upon CBA host countries, and this goes to the CBA organizers, to provide subsidies for local participation. One of the challenges we realized was that despite the need to participate, share lessons, share challenges, and come up with common solutions, there is always limited participation of the local partners. For example, in this country, we have very few people from Uganda, despite the fact that we are hosting. And from this symposium, we called upon the need for providing subsidies to local actors and communities to be able to attend and participate in this conference. Current costs are very prohibitive, leaving out many of the local actors despite hosting the conference. Thank you very much. These were the main highlights that came out of the National Symposium. We wanted to share because we believe it's the first ever symposium that has been held pre the international conference, and we made a resolution to continue with this dialogue and that platform, and we'll continue discussing and sharing lessons, and we hope that the key messages that are derived from this international conference will still be taken forward at the national level using that platform that was created. Thank you very much.